It was a pretty average season in terms of the numbers of storms. There were 13 storms, and the average, the 30-year average, is 12 storms. But there were only two hurricanes, and we did not get a Category 2 or higher hurricanes, first time since 1968 that has happened. So there's a look at the one storm that made landfall in the U.S. That was Tropical Storm Andrea. Then here are the remaining 13 storms. There were two hurricanes once again. One of those was Umberto, way out here in the Atlantic. The other one was Ingrid in the western part of the Gulf of Mexico, but most of the storms were fairly weak. So what happened this season? Well, part of the answer may lie in this. We saw a big area of upper level high pressure in the northeast part of the Atlantic. And this, by the way, is something that we've been seeing a lot more of in recent years that does appear to have a climate change signal. And that upper level high sat there in the northeast part of the Atlantic, and we saw very strong anomalous winds, which is to say winds that are different from what we usually see, very strong winds coming down from Europe and into the middle of the Atlantic. And what those strong winds did is they brought down quite a bit of dry air, and they also created a certain amount of sinking in the atmosphere. So that is not conducive for the development of tropical systems, and this is the main area where these tropical systems develop. That's called the main development region. So just not a lot of activity this year, and of course, hardly anybody is complaining.